The Nottingham University Hospitals is one of the largest NHS organisations in the country. We employ approximately 12,000 people. We have approximately 2,500 beds, 110,000 outpatient episodes a year. There are approximately 500 people a day walk through our emergency department, which is one of the busiest in Europe. And we're a very large organisation, over a 130-acre site.
The problem with papers and files is that they are completely inefficient.
Before we had packs, we had to carry large and heavy packets of X-ray films.
We used to have problems with the paper notes. Insofar as patients used to come in, they used to make an appointment. It was all in a large book.
The way in which we work now means that information needs to be available in a number of different places at a number of different times, and that's physically not possible with the paper records that we hold.
I think the challenges facing the emergency department are varied. Because of the volume of patients we have coming through, somewhere around 450 a day, it's very difficult to actually make sure that all patients get all the treatment and the care that they need in an expeditious way.
One of the problems with operating theatres, if you've got a complex like QMC, where there are 30 theatres, you can have as many as 100 patients a day coming through. What we would like to see in terms of effective management of theatres is early booking, clear understanding of the patients that we're likely to see coming through the theatre and the requirements they have in terms of instrumentation and products which we have to purchase to enable the procedure to be undertaken.
The PAC system changes in a fundamental way the way we look at X-rays and scans, because they're now digital. You can manipulate them by magnification with scans, you can carry out reconstructions in different planes, you can select out vessels and look at them independent to other structures. So from a diagnostic point of view, it adds so many tools that just were not available when we were looking at single images on fixed pieces of film.
PAS is abbreviation for Patient Administration System. All the patients that come to the hospital, all their generic details are stored on file. So all of our major systems, such as ORMIS, interface directly with our PAS system. ORMIS as a system is a management tool. It looks at the utilisation of operating theatres.
EDIS stands for an Emergency Department Information System and has two parts to its role. The first is to provide management information to care for patients, and the second part is to actually contain the clinical record for the patient.
The good thing about ORMIS is it understands the patients, we get advanced booking, it can start to look at where patients may conflict with each other due to instrumentation, and a much clearer picture of how our systems are used to get the most benefit out of the money that's put into the department.
I come back from Hong Kong and I'm a bit concerned because I seem to have a...
Well, it's revolutionised the practice, and there's an area of calm about the practice because everything seems to run smoothly because we have this instant access to all the information we need.
Toughbook works by receiving a signal from our control department, and we put a job number in and we download the information that the controllers input on the screen when they're receiving an emergency call. The admission process has speeded up slightly because in the hospital they've got a separate screen. They can view information coming on as we input the information. The copy is stored on the national database so we can retrieve this information easier than we can on the paperwork. It's a better, accurate record.
ORMIS impacts on patients by making their journey through theatre safer.
With our PAC system, we've already started linking our PAC system to our local hospitals so that we can now retrieve the images immediately at a time when you need them.
The new systems that are now coming on stream will, I think, provide clinicians with real tools to manage their workload and to care for patients effectively. critical success factors in Nottingham, I think, were really around the ownership and the partnership between ICT and the clinicians in the department.
Without a shadow of a doubt, it's the people that have been involved in implementing the change.
I think the big success was how we coordinated people.
Media coverage of Connecting for Health is, unfortunately, almost unerringly negative.
For me, it's quite frustrating because we've made such massive difference to the way in which patient care is delivered here in Nottingham.
You have doctors who are much more relaxed, much more able to focus on the job in hand and focus on the patient.
The PACS implementation has been stunningly successful. It will be completed by the end of this year. It will benefit virtually every single person in this country at some stage in their life.